Jeff and Jeremy in the morning.
Thursday.
It's a crazy week, man.
Tomorrow is the KZOZ takeover. We're really excited about that. It's going to start at this time tomorrow morning. It'll go 13 hours. We'll play nothing but your requests. Every request comes with a donation.
It's been such a hectic week. I have no, like, I have not prepared for the marathon that is tomorrow.
It's called coffee, dude.
No, I don't know if there's enough coffee. I mean,
Make sure you pack yourself a lunch.
I've been working super late nights. Like, I've been up till midnight every night this week. Just working on things. Doing a lot of form filling out. Things along those lines.
What forms?
Oh, forms for homes. And
oh, because you're buying a house?
Yeah.
Oh, so nothing work related. You're just talking about your personal
life. Well, and I have a fair amount of work to do, too. Because it's golf card season, and those things are selling like hotcakes. There's a plug.
Ding.
CentralCoastGolfCard.com. 10 rounds of golf for $119. I'm just not prepared. Usually I get a good night's rest, and tonight is going to be impossible to get a good night's rest because, you know what? Thursday night football. And I normally wouldn't care about Thursday night football, but this is a very interesting game. Because the Rams are currently in first place in the NFC West. But our foes, our nemesis, ours being the Seattle Seahawks, the New England Patriots could actually help out the Seattle Seahawks tonight, coming off of a dominant 45-0 beatdown of the Los Angeles Chargers.
The Chargers and the Rams, come on. They play in the same building, but they're different teams.
I know. But they didn't have to travel back home. They stayed in town.
I would love to see the Patriots beat the Rams.
No distractions.
Sorry, Ram fans.
COVID lockdown.
Just ram it.
I'm telling you, Bill Belichick, they're still fighting for a playoff spot, the New England Patriots. So they're going to want to win this game. This is actually a good Thursday night football game.
You being a California kid, Cameron, and playing the Red Zone Challenge, do you have a team? Do you follow football?
No, not really.
Oh, okay.
I don't really follow football outside of this.
I feel like everybody here is outside of this, yeah. Everybody here is either a 49ers fan or most likely they're a Raiders fan. Every once in a while you get a Chargers fan or, you know, you get a Rams fan. But the Rams have been, you know, just recently back in L.A. It'll be interesting. The Rams are right now an 83% favorite in the Red Zone Nation, 83% of the Red Zone is picking the New England Patriots. I'm sorry, to lose and the Rams to win.
Oh, yeah. So, Rams are hot right now. The Rams are super duper hot.
How many Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday games do we have this week? Oh, look at that. So far, just one normal Sunday night game and one normal Monday night game.
I love it. Let's keep it that way. I'm telling you, I believe there's something to this herd immunity because it seemed like it was running rampant through the NFL. And now it's not as rampant as it is. And now the rest of the country, we're seeing this surge all over the place and they're testing a lot more, but they test every day in the NFL. And, it's like, you know, maybe there's something to, you know, everybody catching it and then moving on. But the problem with that is you could die if you catch it.
So in the NFC West right now, you got the San Francisco 49ers who are at 5-7. Seahawks and the Rams are tied at 8-4. And who am I forgetting? Rams, Seahawks, 49ers.
The Cardinals.
No, I already said the Cardinals.
That's it. There's only four teams.
Didn't I?
Four teams per conference. That's how it works.
Oh, no, I did forget them. What about the Chargers? No, they're not our
conference.
Nope. Arizona's at 6-6. So, yeah.
You know what you pain's
important
me?
Weekend.
To sit here and listen to you try to work your way through this as a guy that does not know that there's four teams in every division.
I know there's four teams in every division.
You thought there was an off chance that the Chargers could be in the NFC West, and here you sit in the fantasy football playoffs, and I'm on the outside looking in.
Actually, if you heard what I said, I said, no, the Chargers aren't. I was just talking it out loud.
No, I know you're talking they're not. It out, but there was a glimmer of doubt.
You're a really bad listener.
I know
that's
for certain that the Chargers aren't in the NFC West. That's how big of a fan of football I am.
Okay, good for you.
I am not in the playoffs, and you are.
Go fill
that
out some forms.
That pisses me off.
Go fill out some forms, would you, right?
Yes, sir.
We don't have a lot of faith in that date being the date. We think she's going to get out before that. Judy's got the 24th, Christmas Eve, which I think is probably the best.
If you had to repick, would you pick that date?
If it was available, I would pick Christmas Eve or Christmas Day. I have the 21st, which is a Monday before Christmas. And Jeff, your date is coming up very soon, isn't it?
15th.
Yeah, so next week.
And I just went 10 days before Christmas. It was totally arbitrary. In hindsight, if I had to pick, I would have looked at the calendar before picking, but I wanted to get that initial pick out there. So I was like, oh, I'll go the 15th. Because I think I was like the first one to pick, and you were the second one, and you rushed your pick too. Everybody else much more methodic in their picks. Cameron said, okay, this is the day they said she's getting out. I'm going with that one, which might be a good pick. You know, maybe they're like, hey, you know what, Aunt Becky, just, we don't want, does, I mean, do you want to be known as the judge or the, maybe the, even the jail that let Aunt Becky out early because there was so much outrage from the public about the college admissions cheating scandal? I mean, maybe she has to serve the whole sentence. Maybe Cameron scores $120.
Yeah, that's very true. I mean, that could very much happen. I just have a feeling that it's not going to happen that way.
What are you going to do with your $120?
I'm going to donate it to the KZOZ takeover.
Wow.
Well, the takeover will be over, but the firefighters, the Slow County Firefighters Benevolent Association, that's who you're going to donate it to?
The what association?
Benevolent.
Benevolent?
Yeah. Look it up if you don't know what it means. It means charitable. I thought we talked about this.
He was trying to get you to say it many times.
Benevolent. Yeah, I can say it just fine now. I go home and I say it every night. But I don't have to put up any crap from you.
Can the NFC West cellar dweller Los Angeles Chargers?
The reason I bring it up is Joe Exotic, the Tiger King, is looking for help. He's serving a 22-year sentence for hiring a hitman to kill Carol Baskin.
Relation to Miles.
Miles, no.
Gaskin.
He's turning to
Miles Gaskin.
He's turning to Kim Kardashian for help because she's helped get other prisoners released early. He's already asked Donald Trump for a pardon, and now he's like, Kim, I need your help. Please, whatever you can do. He writes,
oh, this is nice. We got a long pause, meaning Jeremy's pre-reading because Cameron's got him on his heels with the pronunciation of words. I love this.
I'm writing you this letter, not as Joe Exotic, but as a person. Joseph Maldonado Passage. Asking you to please help me.
He's a Maldonado, really?
By just taking 10 minutes out of your life and placing a call to President Trump to look at my 257-page pardon. It's all the evidence. It's all there. I'm innocent. And I asked him to sign my pardon so I can return home to my husband, Dylan, and my father. Everyone is so busy making movies, getting interviews, lip-syncing country songs.
Joe Exotic, no, nobody's busy. I know you're on the inside, but nobody's busy right now.
Selling stuff and dressing up like me that everyone forgot. I'm a real person. I'm in prison. And it's kept me from telling my story about something that I didn't even do.
Is there...
No one...
I'd like to see the physical letter and see if there's little droplets on the ink from crying. Because he's a crier. If you remember the show, he cried a lot.
He's a sensitive man.
On the show. I mean, he was a crier.
Yeah, he's a big sensitive man.
And you know he's crying while he's... And I believe he can turn it on and turn it off. Because he's also, I believe, a killer. So... I mean, he is a guy that is a very good actor, is what I'm saying. I think he probably got a little tear on there and then daubed it on the
paper. Do you think
paper.
He was set up?
No.
You believe he hired a hitman?
I believe he hired the worst hitman that he could possibly hire.
You mean the kind that turns you in?
I think he's a bumbling idiot. That's why he's in prison, because he hired the worst hitman that you could hire. Like a guy, you're like, you look like you killed some people. Go kill this person. The guy's like, give me $10,000. Okay, goodbye. I'm going to the opposite direction.
So he took his $10,000 and then reported him.
Yes.
Yeah.
I mean, that's breaking the law.
He says, call Donald Trump and tell him. He says, no one has to know you did it.
Oh, well, I got cut trying to kill someone. Help me.
Boy, this is his last chance, though.
I don't think he did it. I think this is a big conspiracy to get rid of.
I know. Everybody likes to think that.
It was a big conspiracy to get rid of Joe Exotic, Tiger King.
I think
Carol Baskin set up the whole thing, and I think she killed her husband and fed him to the tigers.
This is what you have to ask yourself, though, because that's the intrigue of the story. But is this world necessarily a better place with Joe Exotic on the outside? Not really.
It's not for me to judge that. I'm not going to get the answer I want. I want more Tiger King.
I know.
I think it is a better place with him out of jail.
You know what? It's so funny.
I want him to do a reality show when he gets out and he gets back with his husband.
So let's break this down.
I thought his husband killed himself.
He did, but he's got a new husband.
Oh, okay.
The guy, remember, went on a date with a guy, and then they're like getting married at the end of the night. It was ridiculous.
I missed that one, I guess.
You know, I know you probably fast-forwarded through that part because you didn't want to see any of it.
I might have done that. I might have fast-forwarded through that
part. But it's a very interesting dynamic with Joe Exotic, because this is really his last chance. He's not going to get a pardon from Biden, okay? A presidential pardon. And I think it's kind of cockamamie, except for...
Yeah, because Biden's not an animal lover.
Except for, with Trump... By the time he can push those pardons through, he may be so disenfranchised with his loss that he, and I got to think, you know, he's a bit of an attention seeker, Donald Trump. So this could grab some headlines for a day or two, and he goes ahead and he pardons him. And as a way to say, middle finger to everybody.
Yeah, but the problem is, Jeff, he's planning, from what I've heard, on having a big rally party on the same day as the inauguration. He's going to fly Air Force One down to Florida, down to his, Mar-a-Lago. And they're going to have a big party down there, and it's going to be relaunching his campaign for 2024.
Whoa.
And yeah, so he's going to run again.
I don't think you can fly Air Force One because it's no longer your plane.
No, I think it is. On the last day he can have it, he's going to fly it. I think it's a one-way ticket. He just flies down there and they turn around and leave.
Is he going to hold Air Force One hostage at Mar-a-Lago?
No, because I think he's going to run again. I think he might run again in 2024. So
what's he going to run on? I got the plane still.
I got the code to the wet bar.
Possession's 9/10 of the law.
No, I've heard that he's going to have a big party down there on the inauguration day for Joe Biden when he gets inaugurated. And so, because, you know, typically, I guess I don't watch a lot of inaugurations. Is it common for the president to be there handing off the baton to the new president?
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah, no, I think that's part of the process, yeah.
Was Barack Obama there for Trump?
Yeah, Barack Obama.
Oh, he was there?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Nobody else was there. That's why you didn't know about it. Because, like, remember?
I don't remember watching it. I've never watched an inauguration happen. I've seen news clips of one. But, okay. So, yeah. So, my point is, if he's going to run again, I don't know if it's a good idea for him to pardon him. But if he's not going to run again, then, like you said, I agree.
No,
middle finger, I'm out. Drop the...
We have such a good...
You know, here's my theory.
Okay.
He's going to pardon Joe Exotic as a way to take the eyes off of him pardoning the rest of his team that are currently being convicted.
So who is somebody controversial?
Was it Michael Flynn?
Michael Flynn's already been pardoned.
Yeah, he's been pardoned. And the charges were dropped.
Who was the guy? There's a guy.
I
can't think of his name. I know who you're talking about. The guy's got white hair.
Yeah.
Ugly, goofy looking.
Yeah, guy. Yeah. He looks like the guy, like a clown.
Giuliani's not arrested.
Giuliani's fine. He's up. He's on the up and up.
Yeah, I don't think Cameron could name any of these people. Let's see.
I just named one.
Let's see.
No, Michael Flynn was already out. Doesn't count.
Let's see. Here we go. I need pictures.
I can't name them either, so I'm not saying I'm any better than you. But I know there were a fair amount of people that got imprisoned on that have ties to Donald Trump. I can see. I see where you're coming from with this. He's like, by the
Paul
way,
Paul Manafort.
I got Paul Manafort.
Thank Steve
you.
Bannon.
Yes.
Where's the guy I'm trying to find though?
Enough of that. Okay, so this is how. This
and then
is,
Joe Exotic, by the way, this is a story.
So
out
he
of
can
the
come out and he said, "You
magazine.
Know what? I am pardoning today. I have a big, or tomorrow I have a big announcement. Tune into Fox News at 2 o'clock. I'm going to be on Hannity, and then the big announcement on Hannity, which will crush Hannity, will be I am releasing Joe Exotic and Paul Manafort and what was the other guy?
Steve Bannon.
Steve Bannon and Paul Manafort are also getting released.
Cameron, you're a gamer, right?
Yes, sir.
Have you heard of the PS5, the new PlayStation?
The one no one can get, yeah.
Yes, that's it. I guess there was a rumor that started in Detroit at a Walmart that they had one. And so everybody showed up to see what it's about.
Hey, look at this. How long you guys tried to get this PlayStation?
For 12 hours.
12 hours yeah. You've been here?
Yes, sir.
Why is it so important to get one of these?
We need them.
God, that's the most annoying news guy I've ever heard. But
is that a news guy?
Yeah, that was a news guy trying to sound shocking.
Honest to God, I thought it was somebody.
Like a clown?
Trying. Bozo, the news guy.
Right.
Look at this. How long you guys tried to get this PlayStation?
Do it. Yes, sir.
Why is this so important to get one of these?
Where was your horn, jackass?
I honestly thought it was a guy that was wanting to be a news guy, like he just had a phone
and then he was shooting his audition tape.
Yeah, basically his audition tape for the news.
Oh my gosh, everybody was camped out, sub-zero temperatures, right? We're talking Detroit in December. I mean, it's very cold. It was very disappointing too.
When the doors opened, a stampede of people went into the store
and people were wanting to get in. Look at this.
Only to find out that Walmart had no PS5s.
They have none in stock. So if we were told that they're going to have them in stock Monday and we waited 7 hours in the freezing cold of 28 degrees, why is there zero stock?
Because you're an idiot. Because you shouldn't believe everything you read on the internet or is social
that,
media.
Is that really?
Whatever you want to say.
I don't know about gaming systems. I actually, well.
Let's ask Cameron. I don't know anything about him either.
PS5, why so in demand?
The graphics, man.
I think it's a combination of a lot of people wanting it at once and then scalpers.
So this is like the Tickle Me Elmo. I know you're probably too young to even remember Tickle Me Elmo, but back in the... Yeah, you are, because you weren't even born yet. Back in the...
You still sell Tickle Me Elmo.
Right, but like back in... God, I want to say it was like the early 90s. Tickle Me Elmo came out, and it was like people fighting each other over Tickle Me Elmo. And then they're like, well, we're a toy manufacturer. Why don't we just make more? So they just flooded the market. Now they're not valuable, but the idea was that these things were going to be valuable because they only made so many of them. Kind of like a Popeye's chicken sandwich and kind of like a PlayStation 5.
I had that Popeye's chicken sandwich. It just tastes like a chicken sandwich to me.
I will give
it did
this.
Not win me over. I was this is not worth dying for.
It lives up to the claim that it is better than the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich. I truly believe. And Popeye's fried chicken in any shape, way, or form is excellent. I love yes. Popeyes.
I love their chicken. I mean, their chicken is the best.
I got something the other night. God, it's so good. It was called the Surf and Turf, right? But the Popeyes version of the Surf and Turf is shrimp.
They have shrimp at Popeyes?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't
because
know
of Louisiana, right?
Oh, yeah. You know? Yeah.
And bum, 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 it was bum, chicken bum. Strips. And I normally don't do chicken strips because they're not good.
Yeah.
But Popeyes, something about their breading.
Was it the same as they do on the chicken, or was it a little different?
Yeah, it was the same that they do on the chicken.
Do they still have that Louisiana hot sauce?
Yes. Oh. And they got all that, all those weird accoutrements, like the Louisiana stuff. I mean, that I like
red
that.
Beans.
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
yeah. That's, dirty rice.
That's what I'm sorry. What were we talking about? I'm hungry.
PlayStation 5.
Oh, yeah.
PlayStation, yeah. 5. PlayStation 5. All right, you ready? You want to know where you can find the PlayStation 5 here in San Luis Obispo County? Cameron, do you want one?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, then you don't have to worry about getting in line. This is where you can find it. The PlayStation 5 that everybody's looking for. I have no idea. I have no idea where it's at. Sorry. It is not here. We have not heard that it's anywhere. I'm guessing you would buy it at your, you know, Best Buys and your Walmarts and things like that. But as of right now, just going to have to.
Subscribe to the Jeff and Jeremy podcast now on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google, and YouTube. It's your Central Coast commute-friendly podcast.